your presence where there is fullness of joy and all other pleasures that we need. We are going to have an encounter with you today. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
We may be seated.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
It's a wonderful day that we have come into the house of the Lord. If there is something that is very precious, it's coming in the house of the Lord. There was a time that David said that a day spent in the house of the Lord is better than thousands elsewhere. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And in the house of the Lord, there is deliverance. In the house of the Lord, there is salvation. In the house of the Lord, there is healing. In the house of the Lord, there is the encounter with God, a God who knows us by our names. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
A God who knows even the number of hair on your head. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
When we think about how this God is so great, and yet he is mindful of you. He is mindful of man. There was a time that David asked, who is man that you are mindful of him? If we contemplate of how great God is, just like we have sung today, and no matter how great he is mindful of you. He is mindful of me. He cares deeply about us. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I want us to read the word of God from the book of John chapter 3. John chapter 3, I'm going to start from verse 1. And we're going to read. There was a man of the Pharisee named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. And the same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art the teacher, come from God. And no man can do this miracle that you do except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus said unto him, How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? And Jesus answered and said, Verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. And that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said unto you, you must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but you cannot tell when it cometh and when it goes. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said unto him, How can this things be? Jesus answered and said unto him, Art thou a master of Israel, and you know not these things? Verily, verily, I say unto thee, we speak that which we do know, and testify that we have seen, and you receive not our witness. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Unless a man is born of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. We have started another new year, and during this season, it's a time where people make so much resolution. Maybe you are there, you have a list of the things that you want to achieve, you have a resolution of the new year. And in the months of January, February, there's a lot of energy on improvements. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
There is a lot of energy, a lot of drive, because people have goals, people have expectation. Because a new year brings new expectation, it brings new hope. Praise the name of the Lord. And I just want to ask you a question. As you planned your year's resolution, what percentage did you give to the spiritual growth? Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I don't want you to answer me that. But what percentage did you give to spiritual growth? Because maybe you have in your new year resolution, I'm going back to school. Maybe I'm going to buy a new car. I'm going to get another job. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Am I speaking to somebody?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm going to be happy more. I'm going to be laughing more. I'm going to have strategies to reduce stress and also improve my communication. But what percentage have you given to your spiritual growth? Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
We have read about a man who was a ruler in the days when Jesus was on earth. And this man had followed Jesus from afar. He had seen the great miracles that Jesus was doing. And he felt like, I need understand more. I need to get closer to the Lord. I need to go and ask him some questions. Praise the name of the Lord. And the Bible says that he came by night because he was afraid of his tutors. Maybe when the other Jews knew that he's associated with Jesus, that would lower his dignity. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Because of his position, he was afraid to go to Jesus during the daylight. So he went at night. And he went with a testimony. He said, we know that you have come from God. We know that you are sent by God. Because no man can do what you do except by God. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
I don't know how many can testify of you today that no one can do the things you have done except somebody who walks with God.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how many can say the things you do and the things you say corresponds. Praise the name of the Lord. But Nicodemus went with a testimony. He went and told Jesus all the things you have been doing, the miracles you have been doing, the teachings you have been teaching. It is a witness. It is a testimony that God is with you. And it is my desire that this 2017, that we are going to be people who are walking, and not just walking, but walking the talk. We talk. Praise the name of the Lord. And Nicodemus was drawn by the way that Jesus was doing. Nicodemus was drawn by the talk that Jesus was giving, the teachings that Jesus was teaching. Praise the name of the Lord. And because he was drawn by that, that is why he came to seek more information. I believe that this is an year where men and women who do not know the Lord will come to seek your God, will come to ask you a question. How do you do it? Why are you ever happy? Why are you smiling even in hard times? And you can have an answer for them. Praise the name of the Lord. And the Bible says that Jesus gave Nicodemus the strategy. The strategy, the gate where everything begins. The Bible says that for one to enter into the kingdom of God, you must be born again. We cannot give people what we do not have. You cannot tell people about Jesus if you do not have Jesus in your heart. You have to take that first step of accepting Jesus, believing in him. Praise the name of the Lord. The Bible says that whoever believes in the Lord and confesses, he shall be saved. So now Jesus is giving Nicodemus the strategy. You must be born again. There has to be a renewal. Praise the name of the Lord. And you know, when we talk about being born again, this man was like, I'm old. Because his mind went to the kind of understanding. How can an old man go back to his mother's womb and then be born again? Praise the name of the Lord. But man is made up of the body, the spirit, and the soul. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Yes, you were born once when you were physically born. And there was the sound of joy. And the women said, a visitor has come. You were called a visitor. Praise the name of the Lord. But there is another rebirth. There is another birthing that is expected. That which is born of spirit is spirit. Praise the name of the Lord. The physical birth, the physical body is limited. I cannot be here today, right now, and be elsewhere. I can only be here right now. Praise the name of the Lord. But the Bible says that Jesus told Nicodemus that the wind blows. You hear it, but nobody can say where it came from or where it's going. And that is the illustration that Jesus gave of that which is born of the Spirit. Praise the name of the Lord. Somebody who is born of the Spirit is somebody who cannot be limited. You cannot be limited by evil forces. You cannot be limited by the limitations of men. You cannot be limited even by the intellects of men. Praise the name of the Lord. That which is born of the Spirit is spirit. And it overcomes. It overcometh the world. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
It is my desire today, because we are going to have more time even in the second service, and we are going to continue expounding on this, about that which the Spirit, a spirit. What made the disciples of Jesus to undergo great persecution and continue singing Amazing Grace? What made those that were ahead of us, those that were martyred for Christ, what made them keep going on? What made Stephen, even when he was stoned, he said, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. It is not because of his body. It is because he was born again. His spirit was alive. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
And when your spirit is alive, you connect with the Spirit of God. You connect with the Holy Spirit. Praise the name of the Lord. And the famous verse in the same book, John 3 and verse 16, the Bible says that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And I want us to focus on verse 17, because that is what has held so many people from getting born again in the Spirit. The Bible says in verse 17, for God sent not his Son unto the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. When the Lord came here on earth, he did not come to condemn. What has been holding many people from professing and saying, I am born again, that which is born of the Spirit is Spirit, that liveliness, that power from within, what has hindered many people from experiencing that great joy is condemnation. You are condemned because of your past. You are condemned because of your weaknesses. You are condemned because of your shortcomings. You are condemned because of your failures. You are condemned because of the family you come from or the name you go by. There are so many things that condemn people. But I have come to tell you today that Jesus did not come to condemn the world. We are not supposed to remain in any condemnation. But we can say like Nicodemus, I am going to rise against every condemnation because Jesus came that I may be saved. Mm-hmm. Jesus came that I may be born again, that my spirit may receive life. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Rising above condemnation. And the Bible says that there is therefore now condemnation to those that are in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
For us to be victorious this year, we need to know that there is therefore no condemnation to those that are in Christ Jesus. I don't know whether you are in Christ Jesus. I don't know whether you are feeling like you are a bit down, a bit low. But this year, it is a year of rising above every condemnation. This is a year of walking the talk that we talk. You say you are born again, let's see it. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
You say your spirit is alive, let's see the connection.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible says that you shall know them by the fruits that they bear. This is the year to bear fruits. Fruits that manifest the walk. You walk with the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
That which is born of the Spirit is Spirit, and it overcomes the world. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's start it off. I want you to have a moment of reflection. Go back to that list.